A very good morning all of you.
In the last lecture we have seen how to do the basic and binary arithmetic operation by directly taking the numbers into the particle register. In today's class we are going to do using the memory location, as well as we are going to see binary and basic arithmetic operation using C language.
So what you do is just go to new project as usual. And so since I'm going to write Microvision like the assembly language program, so create a new Microvision project. So go to folder where you have saved all your documents. Let's make a desktop this time. So I'm going to make one folder with indirect addressing. Like you're going to take numbers from a particular memory location. Okay, then fine. So I'm going to keep my file name as indirect. And choose your microcontroller. See, in some old versions, your microcontroller, whatever we are choosing, that comes under Atmel. Now Atmel is acquired by Microchip. So you can choose 8089C51. Say no, because you are writing assembly language programming. Then create a new document or workspace where I'm going to show you how to do the assembly language program with a memory. Let's start program. We start with origin. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to move some value to R0 register. Let's make it 50H. And I'm moving one more value to R1 register. So please listen first, then you can, I'll explain what it is and all, how it's going to work. So I move two numbers to two register, then I'm going to move A comma at the rate R0. I hope everybody knows at the rate R1. I'll explain one by one, step by step, what kind of action takes place when you execute the program. For the timing, let me finish writing. Move . So this is my program. So I'm going to save it in direct.asm. Make sure save it with the proper extension. Then I'm going to add my target file. Okay, now we can execute your program. Your program is ready. So what I'm trying to do is here, if you look at the instructions carefully, first, I'm moving my 50 number to R0 register and 10 to R1 register. Then I'm giving instruction, whatever the value at R0, that means at RAM location 50, R0 is nothing but 50. That means the address location, the RAM at 50 location, whatever the number, they're supposed to move to the A register. In the next instruction, add A comma at the rate R1. That means whatever the value at R1, that means at 10th location of your RAM, that value will be added to your A register, and that value will be stored in the accumulator at the same time. Addition operation will be taken place, as well as it will be stored in the A register. Now I'm moving in the next instruction, whatever the value you got in the accumulator register, I'm moving that to a memory location, the RAM at 60 address. In the next instruction, I'm adding one more time A with R0, that whatever your A is updated with the execution. So whatever the updated A value, that is again going to do arithmetic operation with at the rate R0. That means at 50 location, whatever the number you are going to have, that number will be added to accumulator register, and results will be stored again in the accumulator register. So I'm going last instruction, move 70H comma A, means whatever the value in A accumulator register, that will be transferred to a memory location in the RAM at 70 address. So this is a program that we are going to first to translate this program into machine language. So no errors, no warnings. Then build the targets, then go to project, go to options for target one, then change the crystal frequency to 11.0592, then go to output, create exa file, then go to debug, remove the run to main window tick mark, then press OK and save it once again. Now your program is ready to debug. I'm going to debug my program now. So please listen. Now I'm going to I have to define my number at 50 location as well as 10th location, because I'm going to do the arithmetic operation at this memory location. So I need to first see the memory location. That means you have to go to view. Please remember this very, very important. If you want to access the memory, go to view. If you go to memory window, you're going to get memory window here. You can see here, this is your address. You have to type your address. Suppose you are, you can see here, you have to type D semicolon 0 into 50, like 0x into 50. Then you're going to get the memory location of RAM at 50. Now I'm going to change my memory location 50 with some memory. You need to double click it, nothing else. So what you do is go to view, go to memory windows, memory one. Then click your address which you are given 50. That means you are supposed to type, look at here, it is giving 0x0050. That means this is your address. I'm just typing D. If you keep D, means you're going to access the RAM locations. So at 50, I'm going to, at 50 location, I'm going to give my number as 03. Please remember, at 50 location, number 3 is stored. Now I'm going to take my 10th location. 10th location, I'm giving 4. Just double click that memory location, just edit. So now it's very clear, your 50 memory locations having number 3 and 10 memory location having number 4. Okay, now I'm going to execute my program step by step. Now we'll try to see, and your results will be stored in 60 memory location as well as 70 memory in the RAM address. So if I execute one by one, let me keep my register windows here so that you can see. So here, the moment when you start first instruction, move R0 comma 50H, your 50 is moved to R0 register. You can see here, your R0 register value changed to 50. And second instruction, if you look at here, your R1 register moved to, like your 10 number is moved to R1 register. In the third instruction, if you look at here, move A comma at the rate R0, that means whatever the value in 50 memory location, that has to move to the A register. So if I try to see once again 50 memory location, your 50 memory location having number 3. So the moment I press the next instruction, this number 3 will move to the accumulator register. If you look at here, you can see here the value in the 50 memory location has moved to the accumulator register. If I press next instruction, it is going to add A comma R1 at the rate R1. That means your 3 will be added to at the rate R1. At the rate R1 is 10th location. So you go to 10th location, like 10th memory location. So 10th memory location having number 4. That means your 3 and 4 will be added. And 3 plus 4 will be 7. 7 will be stored in the accumulator register. I'm going to execute add instruction. You can see here immediately your A is changed with 7. That means 4 plus 3 is 7. In the next instruction, whatever the 7 I'm having in the A register, that's supposed to move to the memory location 60. So I'm going to see first 60 memory location whether it's having any number or not. So if I look at here, your memory location 60 doesn't have any, it is showing 00. Now if I execute the next instruction, your 60 memory location will be filled with 7. Now you can see here clearly where I'm putting my pointer, your 60 memory is filled with 7. In the next instruction, add A comma R0. That means whatever the value you accumulate in the accumulator having 7 number, and your R0, if you look at here, your R0 value means 50 memory location. So your 50 memory location having 3 number, that means your 7 is going to add it to 3, and the 10 means hexadecimal number A will be stored to the accumulator register in the next instruction. If I execute next one, you can see here your accumulator register is changed with A. So if I execute one more instruction, whatever the value in the accumulator register, that will move to 70 memory location in the RAM. So let me see whether 70 location having any number or not. If I check it, you can see your 70 memory location is 0 right now. The moment I execute the next instruction, your accumulator values will be stored in the 70 memory location. You can see here your 0A is stored in the 70 memory location. This is how you can access the memory location to execute the arithmetic operations. Memory location in the RAM, and you can recall the RAM with at the rate R0, at the rate R1, whatever the code you are supposed to use, and you can execute the instruction. Okay, this is how you can access the memory locations to change to any arbitrary number. Need not be a fixed number, you can change any arbitrary number depending on your requirements. This is all about other programming. Now we'll try to see how to write a C program in Keil to do the binary arithmetic operation as well as the basic arithmetic operations. Okay, so I'm going to close this debug session. I'm going to create a new window, a new MicroVision project. So as I said, every time you try to create a new folder, so I'm going to do basic arithmetic operations. So I'll make it basic arithmetic operations, in which I'm going to create a folder called basic. This time you choose same microcontroller, do no change. One thing is, this time you said you this time you press yes, because you're going to write our code in C language, so you need this yes this time. Okay, then you create a new window. Just write one program for a simple arithmetic operations. Just please follow for the time being, and I'll explain one by one once it is done. So first, we are going to write header as usual, what you do it in C++. What the only thing is, in that case, you write include.studio.h. In this case, you're going to write reg51.h. So this has all the library files, whatever is required for our work. Then start void main, then start your programming here. It's going to define unsigned integers or unsigned characters. I'm defining characters x, y, z. Then I'm going to define one s, one m. I'm going to close this line. Then I'm going to give my x number as 2 and y as 3. It's as like your simple normal C programming. Now I'm going to define my output ports. See, when I do the arithmetic operation, you are supposed to see the output, right? So you have to define your output ports. For that, you have to see, if you look at your 8051 microcontroller architecture, you have total four input and output ports, that is 8-bit input and output ports. I'm going to use those ports for our result display. First, I'm going to clear those ports. That means I'm going to make P1 as 0. Then I'm going to make P2 also 0. Just to clear the output ports, nothing else. And I'm going to make P3 also, because we are going to do three arithmetic operations. Make sure write the capital P, don't write small p here. Now you cleared all your port. Now you define your arithmetic operation. I'm going to define my z as x. I'm going to define my character x plus y, z equals to x plus y. Then s equals to x minus y. Then m equals to x into y. So if you look at here, x minus y is better, we'll keep x is 3 and y is 2. Just for the simplicity, it will be easy for us to understand first program. So I define my all the arithmetic operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication. Now I'm going to define the output, where my z is supposed to appear, addition of two numbers, where my subtraction should appear. I'm going to define P1 port for my addition. That means P1 supposed to produce the output of z value. And I'm going to define my P2 port for subtraction, and P3 port for multiplication. And you can close your. So this is a basic C programming. Most of you already did this kind of programs. Many, you define three integer numbers, x, y, z, s, comma, n. Then you define x value and y value. Then you decided which ports you want to use for your output display. Then you define your arithmetic operation. Then you decided on which port, which operation result supposed to appear. Okay. Only thing is, please remember here, whatever the value was assigned, x equals 3, y equals 2, it will be assigned to the registers R6 and R5, or maybe R6 and R7. It is automatically designed by the like your structure of your microcontroller. So we cannot decide that this x equals 3 supposed to go to R1 register, y equals supposed to go to R3 register, and so on. It will be predefined by the compiler itself, so you automatically take the values. The moment you compile your program, you are going to see the assembly language program for this C program. Please remember, each line of your C program will be converted back to assembly language program, where you are going to see when you type x equals 3, what instruction it is going to take in the assembly language program, where my 3 is going to store. Similarly, when you do the execution results, which register it is going to store, all those things will be discussed in a moment. For the timing, your program is ready. I'm going to save first. So I'm going to save in my folder which I created, basic arithmetic operation. So I'm going to keep as basic.c. Please remember, this time you have to save your file with .c extension, because you have written your program in the C language. Then you can see now characters have changed to different color because you have written program in C language. Now I'm going to add this file to target. So add the existing file. Then choose your, in this case, you are supposed to choose the drop down C. Then you can see there is a called basic C. Then let's check whether we are in the right folder or not. We are in the right folder. So we can add this file and close. Now you can see your file is added. Now you are going to translate this C code to your machine language. So you can see there are many errors. Let me check what are those errors. So there is spelling mistake, unsigned, size. Yeah, now it is fine. Let me run once again. Let me save and run once again. Now you can see here there is no error. See the small spelling mistake also, it is detecting and showing the error. Previously it was R. So there are many errors related to X, Y, Z, S, and M. The moment I change to D, this showing zero errors and zero warning. That means your program is fine. Now you're going to build the target files. It is also done. Now we're going to go to the project. Go to options for the target. Then change the crystal frequency to 11.0592. Then go to output, create exa file. Then go to debug. This time you keep the tick mark, don't remove, because we are using the C programming. So it has to go to the run main to run your program. So let's make it okay. Now again, you can check once again, everything is fine or not. Then go to the debug session. Okay, now you are in your debug session. Now you can, first we'll try to run and we'll try to see. So before that, you need to put your peripherals P1, P2, P3, because where you're going to see the results. Let's go to the peripherals first. Go to input output ports. Let's make P1. Then make peripherals P2. So these are output ports where you are going to see our results, because that's how I defined. Then port 3. Okay, now I'm going to execute my program step by step. You can see here the assembly code for your C programming. Whatever you are able to see in the below window, where I have written my C programming, that equivalent assembly code is generated in the upper window, where you can see here in this C program, I have written x equals 3, but if you look at the assembly program, it is given move R7 comma 3. That means 3 is moving to the R7 register. Similarly, if you look at here, y equals 2, I defined. If you look at here, your 2 is value moved to the R6 registers. You're getting my point now? So whatever you have written code in C language, that will be converted to assembly language by the compiler, where it decides one register. We don't have any choice to decide which register is supposed to transfer. It will transfer to the appropriate register as per the architecture which is designed for your whatever the microcontroller you are choosing. Okay. Now I'm going to run step by step just to make very clear understanding of your C programming. So I'm going to start first one. In the first case, your 3 and 2 are moved to the respective registers. Okay. You can see here 3 is in R7 register now. If I move next one, your 2 also moved to the R6 register. That means whatever the number you have given X and Y, those two numbers are stored in two registers, that is R6 and R7. So this is the first. So that means whatever the number you want to do arithmetic operation, those are stored in two registers. Now if you look at the next instruction, that means you are making your P output port P1 to all zeros. If you look at here now, all are ones. Your port P1 having all the tick mark means all are ones. That's why it's showing 0 into FF. So you can see all the three codes are showing FF. That means all are ones. Now if I execute the next instruction, your port 1 becomes all 0. That means your P1 equals 00 execution has done. If I make one more step execution, your port 2 will become all zeros. If I take one more, your port 3 will be 0. Now your all the ports are cleared for our output representation. Now I'm going to run next instruction. If you look at here, the codes, as I wrote here, Z equals X plus Y, but if you look at in the yellow color line, where your R7 value is moved to A register, then you added A comma R6. That means your 6, your 2 and 3 will be added and results will be stored to A register. Okay. Then the result of A will be moved again to the R5 register. That means your 2 plus 3 will be added, 5 will be generated, that 5 will be stored in the R5 register in the next instruction. So let's see. So here also I did not instruct the compiler to take R7 to A1, R6 to A1. It's already generating based on my C language code. Okay. If I run next instruction, you can clearly see your addition of 2 and 5. You can see here your R7 went to A and R6 went to A, like R6 added to A. That means 3 plus 2 will be 5. That 5 is moved to R4 register. This is internally taken care since we are doing first time. So I'm showing step by step what is taking place in the program at the C level, at the same time assembly level. Okay. Now if I execute one more instruction, you can look at here, your R7 again moved to A register. Then your R6 moved to B register and you have did the multiplication of X and Y. Okay. And the multiplication results again move to accumulator. So that means you are going to have R7, R6. That means 2 into 3 will be 6. 6 supposed to appear at the A1. So if you look at here, see that it's already done the subtraction operation. If you look at here, you are at the line M equals X dot Y. But if you look at the previous line, S equals X minus Y. X minus Y means 2 minus 3, it will be 1. You can see accumulator is having value 1. The same value is stored in R4 register. If you look at here, your R4 is moved to, your R4 value is moved to, sorry, your subtraction value is moved to R4 register. If I execute next instruction, your multiplication instruction will be taken place. That means 2 into 3 will be 6, that 6 will be going to store in the accumulator register. Now you can see here clearly your accumulator has changed to 6 because you multiply 2 and 3, that result is stored in the accumulator register, that is 6. Now, next instruction onwards, please, this is very important. The next instruction onwards, whatever the output results we got it, those output results will be displayed in the output ports. That means, your X plus Y will be 5. That means, whatever the R5 is supposed to go to the P1 port, and X minus Y will be 1, that is R4. Whatever the R4 value is supposed to go to the P2 register, and sorry, P2 output, and whatever the X into Y that's supposed to go to the P3 port. So if I execute the next instruction, if you look at here, assembly language yellow color, your R5 value is going to the P1 port and your R4 value go to the P2 port. This P2 port is defined in this fashion. Okay, if I execute first instruction, your R5 value, that means 5 supposed to move to the port 1. Now you can see here it is 101. 101 is nothing but 5. If I execute one more instruction, your subtraction value, that is X minus Y, that is 1 supposed to go to the port 2. You can see your port 2 is displayed with 001. If I execute one more instruction, that means your multiplication value, that's supposed to be somewhere accumulator register, that accumulator register will go to the P3 port. You can see here, move P3 comma A, that means whatever the value in the accumulator that's supposed to display in the port 3. That means your accumulator value having a 6, that is nothing but multiplication of your two numbers. So if I execute that instruction, we are going to see 6 in the port 3. You can see your port 3 is displayed with 110, that's nothing but 6. This is how you are going to execute the a binary arithmetic operation. At the same time, you can check the assembly language code, how it is generating, what kind of instruction is taking place, which registers are involving in the operation. Okay, so this is how you're going to write your C code. I'm going to close the debug session and come back to my main window. So this is how your C program will run in the appeal programming. Yeah, now we'll try to see one more program, that is a binary, how to do the binary arithmetic operation C programming. Okay, so this is basic arithmetic operation. I'm going to show you how to do the binary arithmetic operation. This is more like same program, just we'll do it for a practice purpose so that you will also get to know. So I'm going to save this thing and I'm going to start a new MicroVision project. So I'm going to create one more folder where I'm going to keep my basic binary this time. Keep the individual folder for each program. So previously basic arithmetics, this one is basic binary arithmetics. Then choose your microcontroller. Then click S. Then create a workspace. Then you're going to write your program here. So let me write. The people who are very, very familiar with C++, very good in C++, they can actually enjoy this coding in 8051, because it's not much difference other than few code things. So then I'm going to start my void menu. I'm going to start my program. So I'm going to define some integers here. Let's make x, y, z, s, comma, m. Then I'm going to make a define x as 2. Then y as 3. Then we're going to define our port. I'm making my p1 also 0. I'm just clearing my port p1 to see my output. Similarly, p2 also same thing, clearing my output port. Then p3. Now you cleared all your output ports for which you're going to display your result. Now I'm going to execute. I'm going to write my binary arithmetic operation. I'm defining my z as x and y. Then define s equals. X, y. Then I'm going to make an equals my p1 for the output to display z and p2 to display my s. You are defining output where you're going to see your result, and p3 to m. And I'm going to close my program. So this is my C program for the binary arithmetic operation between x and y. Your x is 0, 1, 0 and y is 0, 1, 1. We're going to do the binary arithmetic operation. I'm going to save this file. Let's go to binary. Then dot make it as dot C. Save it, then add to the source group. Binary.c. Close, then translate into machine language. So no errors, no warnings. So when you do it first time, you may end up some errors because you may be forgetting these semicolons and all. So don't worry, it just comes with the practice. Then build the target files, then go to project and go to the option for target and change your crystal frequency. Go to output, create exa file, then go to debug. Tick mark should be there, so keep it as this and save it once again. Go to the debug mode. Now same thing, you can always check your assembly language code, what is generating with respect to your C programming. You can look at here, and I gave x equals 2 here, y equals 3 here. You can see here your assembly code is defined. Your move R7 comma 2, that means your whatever the defined for x value, that is moved to R7 register. And what are the value I defined for y value, that is moved to the R6 register. That is defined by internal your your architecture. I'm going to start execute one by one. Before that, let me take my peripherals to see my output at the end. I'm going to use P1 and go to peripherals and go to input output ports, go to P2 port, and similarly go to P3 port and place it here. I'm going to execute one by one. Let's execute first step. In the first step, your R6 and R7 registers supposed to change with the numbers 2 and 3 as per the assembly code generated for your C programming. You can see here first R7 is changed with number 2. If I execute next one, R6 register change with the number 3. That means your X and Y are stored in R6 and R7 register as per your C programming. Now in the next instruction, your P1 port, P2 port and P3 port will be reset to 0. So P1 port reset and P2 port reset and P3 port reset. Then I'm going to execute my arithmetic operation. First one is X and Y. So if you do the end operation of 2 and 3, what I'm supposed to get? You're going to get 2, 0, 1, 0. Or you can say 2 is your answer, right? You can see here my 2 is stored in accumulator register. You can see here it has moved my R7 to A register. Then it has, you can see this assembly code here, ANL A comma R6. That means it's going to do the end operation between a value in the accumulator register and R6 value. That is R6 value nothing but 3. Your accumulator is having value 2. That means going to take the end operation between 2 and 3 and going to produce result A in the A register. The same A value is going to move to the R5 register. That means you can see here your R5 register is moved, changes the value to 2. That means this is the result of end operation between X and Y. If I take XOR operation between X and Y, so what I'm going to get if I do XOR operation bitwise, 001. So if I execute this instruction, if you look at here, your R7 value move to A register and your XRL A comma R6 means that you're going to get to execute the XOR operation of X and Y. Then the next instruction you can see here, your whatever the value is generated here, your XOR operator is moved to the R4 register. Okay. Now if I do one more execution, that is XRY, that means you're going to the R operation between 010 and 011. If I do XOR operation, what I'm supposed to get? 011, that means 3. So in the next execution, you're supposed to see result 3. Let's see where it is going. You can see here it is going to the accumulate register. In the next moment, it is going to store in some register. So it is storing in the accumulate register. So it is end of your execution. So your results, whatever you have done till now, those are stored in R4, R5, as well as accumulate register. In the next step, it's already next step also executed. You can see here my P1 port has changed to 010. P1 port means Z means X and Y. So end operation between X and Y, that means X operation between 2 and 3 is producing 2. That value is coding, like that value is displayed in the port 1. If I execute one more instruction, that means S instruction, that is XRY, that means going to produce 1, that's supposed to store in port 2. You can see port 2 having 001. If I execute one more instruction, your 3 is supposed to appear at port 3. You can see 011. So this is how you can write the C program for a given requirement, and you can execute, and you can also check assembly code how it is taking the values of whatever the inputs you have given, and you can choose which output code you want to see the result. This is how you are going to do it.
This all for today's lab session. In the next lab session, we are going to see how to write a program for ascending order and descending order.